Hey, what's going on YouTube? Chào mừng các bạn đã quay trở lại với channel của mình. Nếu đây là lần đầu các bạn đến với channel của mình thì mình tên là Benjamin. Mình làm video về street style, đời sống và công nghệ. Hiện giờ đang là 9 giờ sáng vào một ngày thứ bảy. Ở video lần này, Ben sẽ lại cùng đưa mọi người đi theo Ben trên một chuyến đi lên trên New York City. Và nếu mà mọi người có nhớ ở vlog NYC lần trước thì Ben có nhắc đến việc nếu mà lần sau đi lên New York, Ben sẽ cố gắng hẹn với lại một thổ dân, một người mà biết rất rõ về New York để có thể đưa Ben cùng với mọi người đi khắp nơi để chúng ta có thể cùng khám phá và trải nghiệm thành phố New York là như thế nào. Và dĩ nhiên thỏa theo mong ước của video trước thì lần này Ben có hẹn với cả một người bạn mà Ben cũng rất háo hức để giới thiệu mọi người. Và để không mất thêm một giây nào nữa, Ben sẽ bắt đầu lên xe lập tức để đưa mọi người đi theo, ok? Woo, it's a beautiful day today. Hiện giờ thì trời đang khá là nhiều mây, ít nắng. Và nhiệt độ hiện giờ trên New York là vào khoảng tầm âm 2 độ C. Nắng sẽ khá to vào lúc 1 giờ trưa. Ra thì hôm nay cũng không phải là một ngày trời quá đẹp, nhưng mà bởi vì những ngày vừa rồi mưa tầm tã, không thì tuyết rơi lả tả. Chính vì vậy có thể nói một ngày hôm nay trở nắng như thế này là một ngày khá là đẹp rồi. Tự dưng vừa mới nói xong thì trời giờ nắng gắt ơi gắt. Và nhân tiện đây, trước khi lên xe thì Ben sẽ break down outfit của mình luôn. Hôm nay Ben mặc một chiếc áo parka. Ban nãy thì Ben định mặc chiếc áo Champion collab với lại Supreme mà có Sherpa, lông Sherpa ở bên trong. Nhưng mà sau khi bước ra ngoài đường thì Ben cảm thấy lạnh quá, thế nên là Ben phải đổi ngay chiếc áo này. Và có thể mọi người biết hoặc không thì chiếc áo Ben đang mặc hiện giờ đây là một trong những chiếc áo lạnh số 1 thế giới, được sản xuất bởi hãng Canada Goose. Và chiếc áo này thực sự là vua của những chiếc áo lạnh. Ben đã từng sở hữu những chiếc áo của The North Face, Stone Island, Timberland, Patagonia. Và tuy chiếc áo nào cũng rất ấm, nhưng thực sự không thể so sánh với chiếc áo Canada Goose ở đây được. Hơn nữa, điều mà Ben đặc biệt thích ở chiếc áo này đấy là kiểu dáng, design rất là urban, rất là modern, rất là hiện đại và trẻ trung hơn nhiều so với những chiếc áo của các hãng khác. Lớp bên ngoài được pha với một chất liệu như là cotton, pha với lại polyester, được bọc bởi một lớp double water repellent, có thể chống mưa và cản gió. Bên trong những chiếc túi áo mà Ben đang để tay đây được làm một chất liệu fleece rất là ấm khi mà để tay vào. Và phần lông ở mũ này được làm bằng lông của sói coyote, để nếu mà đội cái hood lên thì gió không thể nào vào được bên trong. Ben quên mất tên gọi của lining ở bên trong này rồi, nhưng mà tác dụng của nó có thể chống lạnh được từ âm 15 đến 25 độ C. Nói chung về cơ bản thì đối với Ben đây là chiếc áo toàn diện nhất cho mùa đông của năm nay, và đặc biệt phù hợp với những hôm trời lạnh hay là trời có thể trở mưa bất cứ lúc nào như ngày hôm nay. Điểm trừ duy nhất của chiếc áo này là mức giá khá là đắt, và Ben đã phải đắn đo rất nhiều trước khi quyết định bỏ ra hơn 1.000 đô để sở hữu chiếc áo này. Nhưng nếu mọi người sống với thời tiết mà vào mùa đông âm đến mười mấy độ C thì mọi người sẽ hiểu đây thực sự là một essential để có thể sống sót qua mùa đông. Đặc biệt hơn nữa, tuổi thọ của chiếc áo này có thể kéo dài được từ 10 đến 15 năm, thế nên Ben nghĩ đây là một khoản đầu tư hoàn toàn xứng đáng. Và nhân tiện đây, Ben sẽ break down toàn bộ outfit của mình luôn. Ngoài chiếc áo parka của Canada Goose thì ở bên trong Ben mặc một chiếc áo pullover của The Pharaoh, một chiếc quần sweatpants của Champion và đi trên chân một đôi Yeezy 700 Wave Runner. Bởi vì Ben biết hôm nay sẽ đi bộ khá nhiều, thế nên Ben muốn đi một đôi giày vừa thoải mái, vừa hype beast và là một điểm nhấn để có thể kết nối toàn bộ outfit lại thành một tổng thể thống nhất, nhìn rất basic nhưng mà cũng rất là nổi bật. Ok, và trước khi lên New York thì bây giờ Ben phải mang chiếc xe đi rửa đã, bởi vì những ngày vừa qua vừa mưa vừa tuyết, thế nên chiếc xe đã rất là bẩn rồi. Let's go. Oh my gosh, Ben vừa mới bị pull over bởi một ông cop xong. Và đây, ông cop vẫn đang ở đây. Và lý do mà ban nãy Ben bị pull over là bởi vì khi mà vừa mới đến New York thì Ben không biết đường, thế nên là Ben lấy điện thoại ra để mà search navigation Google Maps để có thể đi. Và ở trên này thì hiện giờ luật see cái navigation. Man, thật ra thì đáng lẽ Ben nên dừng lại và sử dụng navigation thay vì là rút điện thoại ra và sử dụng navigation ngay lúc đấy. Và ban nãy thì ông officer có nói là thời gian gần đây thì có rất là nhiều những trường hợp tai nạn xảy ra là bởi vì do người lái xe sử dụng điện thoại. Thực sự mà nói thì ngay cả khi sử dụng điện thoại ban nãy thì Ben vẫn rất là cẩn thận, vẫn rất là an toàn, nhưng mà bởi vì, you know, it is what it is, it's okay. Ban nãy officer có nói là nếu mà ra tòa thì hãy nhận là mình không có lỗi, và nếu mà lúc quan tòa vui tính thì có thể họ sẽ bỏ qua cho cái lỗi này, bởi vì thực sự đây là một cái lỗi mà không phải do... Buồn cười ở chỗ là Ben có cái vlogging camera ở đây thì officer lại không bắt lỗi, trong khi sử dụng điện thoại của mỗi một chút thôi thì lại bắt lỗi. Anyways, cuối cùng thì Ben cũng đã đặt chân lên đến New York. Ban nãy thì bạn của Ben có text và nói là bạn của Ben đang ở một cái cửa hàng để return một cái quần. Thế nên là bây giờ Ben sẽ đón bạn Ben ở cửa hàng đấy. Và Ben rất nóng lòng muốn giới thiệu mọi người về người bạn này. Ben nghĩ hôm nay sẽ là một ngày khá là thú vị, và Ben rất là háo hức để có thể đưa mọi người đi khắp nơi cùng với Ben. Và khác với lần trước thì Ben hứa sẽ đưa mọi người đi rất nhiều nơi, nhiều hơn rất nhiều so với cả vlog NYC vừa rồi. Và hiện giờ thì navigation chỉ là còn 10 phút nữa là Ben sẽ đến gặp bạn Ben. Và trước khi gặp người bạn này thì Ben cũng muốn nói sơ qua một chút. Sorry mọi người, bởi vì chỗ này nắng hơi bị trực tiếp, thế nên là nhìn sẽ hơi bị cháy nắng một chút. Và bởi vì người bạn của Ben tuy là một người châu Á nhưng mà lại không biết nói tiếng Việt, bởi vì bạn của Ben sinh ra và lớn lên ở Toronto, Canada. Thế nên một lát nữa để bầu không khí đỡ awkward hay là để đỡ ngại thì Ben sẽ hạn chế sử dụng tiếng Việt để bạn của Ben không cảm thấy awkward hay là ngại. Tuy nhiên toàn bộ cuộc đối thoại của Ben bằng tiếng Anh, Ben sẽ dịch toàn bộ ở phần subtitle bên dưới. Ben nghĩ đôi khi đổi gió và nói bằng tiếng Anh và subtitle bằng tiếng Việt cũng khá là hay và thú vị, bởi vì biết đâu mọi người có thể học được thêm tiếng Anh. Và rất là nhiều người direct message cho Ben nói là nhờ xem vlog của Ben mà một số người cũng đã cải thiện trình độ tiếng Anh một cách rất là rõ rệt, đặc biệt là cách phát âm. Thế nên Ben muốn thử nghiệm cả việc sẽ nói bằng tiếng Anh và sau đấy thì subtitle bằng tiếng Việt. Dĩ nhiên đây không phải là một điều mà sẽ kéo dài mãi mãi. Tuy nhiên là trong thời gian sắp tới thì Ben muốn giới thiệu với cả mọi người và cũng muốn mang mọi người theo gặp những người bạn của Ben. Và Ben rất là muốn vlog trong tình trạng thoải mái để cả mọi người lẫn cả bạn Ben và Ben cảm thấy thoải mái khi mà...
Hey, where are you?
Hey, what's
nice
up?
To see you, hey, bro.
What's up? I was just introducing you briefly through
the
vlog.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll probably be doing a introduction, like a more...
Yeah, formal, right?
Yeah, formal introduction. But this is Aaron's. So we are probably going to lunch right now.
Yeah.
So you know, like, how to get there, right?
Yeah. I'll just direct you.
Okay. I'm not a good driver.
Okay.
So I actually got a ticket, man. The guy stopped me and he was like, yo, you were using your electronic device while driving.
Is this today?
Yeah.
On the way here?
Yeah.
Wow. And then what, did he give you a ticket?
Yeah, he gave me a ticket, but it was kind of weird because he was like, yo, we kind of have to like give everybody tickets.
Yeah.
But when you go to the court, just plead not guilty.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's what they always do.
I thought runners like Ultra Boost and Yeezy would never go out of style.
Yeah.
But the people made it go out of style because it's so saturated.
Too, oversaturated. I just felt that it just oversaturated the market with the V2s and you know, the game's not really the same. But I do like the fact that he came out with the Wave Runners. Like we were talking about like the chunky sneakers and how a lot of the brands are putting out their own take on it. So I feel that if all these brands are following the same trend of the chunky sneaker, you're going to be used to seeing everyone wearing that too, and then it's going to lose its feel. So the best thing is to have like a solid rotation of variety. Have, you know, like you can always switch it up. You don't have to be feel that you have to be wearing one shoe all the time.
It's like Jordans, Yeezys, Air Maxes.
Have some, mix some designer in there.
Yeah.
Right? Just have like a nice variety. So you don't always feel that you're following one trend, right? Yep.
Have you seen the new Dragon Ball Z collab?
I saw a couple of pictures. I think it's cool for people who are fans of actual Dragon Ball Z.
Yeah.
At least it's something unique, right?
The concept that they made every shoe their own character.
Mm-hmm.
But personally, I'm not gonna buy it.
Yeah.
Because it's too like...
Childish.
Right? Yeah.
So here's a restaurant, Balthazar.
Wow.
Right here on the right. This is a very famous spot.
Wow.
It's been here for a very long time. These guys also own Mineta Tavern, which has the famous Black Label burger. So it's a $33 burger.
Okay.
Right? And it's just, it's the most famous burger in New York.
I heard about it.
Yeah, Black Label. Oh, look, the lineup. What's this for?
What's this for?
Oh, it's for Supreme. So they make everyone line up here and then they call you over and then you have to line up on this side.
What?
See, there's two lineups.
That's crazy.
I always say this, the message behind the culture is always greater than the hype.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
Because that's the hype only lasts for so long. But if you understand the message and you understand the culture behind all of these like cool products or like good events, like Complex Con, this and that,
yeah,
then I think you'll have a better understanding for where the game is heading.
Yep. Hey, what's going on mọi người? Bây giờ Aaron's vừa mới đưa Ben đến một cái nhà hàng. Và đây là một cái nhà hàng rất là nổi tiếng gọi là Baltarza. Và đây là một trong những cái nhà hàng nổi tiếng nhất của New York. Và chắc là kể từ bây giờ thì đây sẽ nói tiếng Anh để mà Aaron đỡ cảm thấy ngại.
Yo, do you want to give a quick breakdown of the outfit?
Yeah, so we got, this is from 1998-1997 release, Supreme Patagonia. Ooh. Windbreaker. We got the Levi's corduroys. And then we got the off-white Prestos. You know, you gotta be comfortable when you walk around New York, right? It's a lot of walking to do, but you still gotta, you know, be somewhat stunning.
That's but here a sick we are. Fit, eh?
Yeah, Baltazar.
Ooh, I'm excited. Yo, look at this place. It's packed. Right now, they don't have a table until like an hour, so I think we're gonna wait for an hour. Yo, I went to the bathroom in there, and yeah, it's crazy vintage.
Oh yeah?
It's so vintage
yeah,
looking.
It's very, like very old-fashioned.
Yeah,
it's the same thing as Mineta Tavern inside. It's like you're in an old tavern in like the middle of like Texas. That's how they modeled it.
Wow.
And then the burger, because it's called Black Label Burger, so they get the meat from a famous butcher in the city called Pat LaFrieda, and he does all of like the specialty cuts. So that's what makes the burger so nice and moist. And it used to be $26, now it's $33, but it's the most famous burger in all of New York. Like they recommend you don't put cheese on it, don't put toppings, just eat it with the meat and the caramelized onions.
Yo, I'm excited to try that next time.
You should have a Nike Create Your Own Air Forces, eh?
Me and Aaron are gonna take a look at the Air Force, make your mark. Here, I'll show you guys.
Some of the designs, it's doing too much, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Like, a lot of credit to Virgil.
Yeah.
Because Virgil's the one who basically, you know, after he did his custom Air Force One, now everybody, they're trying to make their own, take their own spin on it, use their own twist. You can look at the dyes.
Whoa.
So they just dip it, they dip the Air Forces inside, and then after they dip it in here, they put it in the oven right here to make sure that the color really sticks on it.
Okay.
I just find that because there's so many, like there's so many over there, right? It's hard not to get influenced by what other people have done already on it.
Yeah.
What do you like? Do you like Air Force Ones?
I used to.
Mm-hmm.
I was going to wear the Travis Scott today.
Oh, nice, nice.
Yeah.
Those are cool. I like that.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful thing I like about Soho too, that so many of the stores are all in the same area.
Mm-hmm.
So you can get a lot done within a short period of time.
I kind of regret not trying to buy the North Face Supreme this season. It wasn't that cold.
Yeah.
When they
it
released
came out,
it.
Right?
Yeah.
So you didn't really feel the need of having it, right?
But now, man.
See, look. See this? Some notice. Look up there.
Whoa. Notice, right? This collab is not like official, right?
Yeah, it's not official. They just took the.
I told my vlog earlier that, do you want to go inside? Okay, let's go in, see what they have.
Some know this.
Some know this.
We can get into this a bit earlier, but this jacket was released in 1997 by Supreme. So what they did is they took this original Patagonia design, and you know, I think it's better if you explain it in Vietnamese. You don't have to talk about it.
I told my audience that I'm going to be speaking mostly English today.
Oh, okay, okay.
I'll be subtitling.
So we'll start it again, okay? So basically back in 1997, Supreme, they used the original Patagonia design, as you can see. So that's the Avalanche logo. And they took it and instead of the Avalanche, they put the Twin Towers and the New York City skyline on it.
Whoa.
So this is 1997, so that's over 11 years old. And it's funny because now we're in Soho and this is the Patagonia store here. And just like maybe 5 minutes away is the Supreme store. So you see how both brands can collide without each of them even knowing.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, that's Patagonia for you guys. So there was nothing really inside there, you know, besides the Supreme collab. I don't think Patagonia is that hype. However, I think it's like a great winter.
Yeah, it's very high brand. Quality, like North yeah. Face, Canada Goose.
Canada Goose. Right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like your jacket is very functional.
Yep.
You know, like even so in Toronto, Canada Goose are so popular that
I know.
In Yorkdale, there's lineups outside.
Wow.
Outside the stores because what people do is they buy them and they bring them back to China and resell for more.
Wow.
So there's lineups outside the Canada Goose store in Toronto.
That's crazy.
It's crazy, yeah. You would never think that, right? So we're heading right now into Stone Island. This is a really high quality brand from Italy. Now they have a bunch of stores. So they have one here, they have one in LA, and it's just high functional quality Italian sportswear. You're getting good B-roll right now?
So unfortunately they weren't allowing any cameras, but I still got a little bit of footage. Hopefully it's good enough. Most of the stores in New York, it's gonna be hard to film inside, but you know, we're gonna try our best.
Yeah. Because Stone Island, I like the fit too. The fit is very slim fitted.
Mm-hmm.
But the quality of the garments is always high because a lot of the pieces they're made in Italy, Italian, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that attention to detail really shows in their product. You might pay a little bit more, but it'll last you longer. Like I've had a lot of Stone Island pieces that I've washed, including the Supreme Stone Island collabs,
mm-hmm.
and they hold up really well.
Today's actually a beautiful day because it's not that cold,
yeah.
It's not rainy. Or
exactly. Yesterday was rainy, right?
Mm-hmm.
Same in Toronto.
Calm, don't start no trouble with me. Trying to keep it peaceful is a struggle for me. Don't pull up at 6 a.m. to cuddle with me. I don't wanna die for them to miss me. Yes, I see the things that they wishing on me. Hope I got some brothers that outlive me.
So me and Aaron have about 20 minutes to kill right now, and we wanna show you guys a piece of
Supreme history.
Yeah.
Right, a little flashback story.
Yeah.
You know, the very first time that when I was in New York, it was in 2008. Basically, Supreme was not as big as it was now. So
it's not as mainstream as it is right now.
But we'll save that story for when we're in front of there. We'll show you the lineup right now.
Okay, so when we drove by, there's a line back here. So you see all these barriers? They're all for a Supreme line, like these.
Here, get the people on the line right here. Going around.
Whoa. Look how crazy this is. Yeah, check this out, guys. Well, Supreme has like a new system now where everybody like register before.
Yeah, that's for the release dates for Thursdays, but now it's not there, it's Saturday, right? So you just have to line up normally.
What?
Yeah.
What are they buying? Like, what is there to buy?
No pictures, please.
Where's the flag?
someone stole it. There used to be a flag that hung up there, and then the guy stole it, and then he tried to put it up for sale for 15,000, right?
Stop it. Get some help.
Holy yeah, so God. The very first time I came here was in 2008. This is when the Supreme Kermit tea released, the celebrity tea. So I remember coming here and there was none left. Even though back then there weren't crazy lineups like today, people somewhat knew about it, just wasn't as hyped and mainstream, right? So when I first came here and the t-shirt wasn't there, there were these two kids that came up to me and asked me, do I want to see a secret Supreme store? And wow. In my head, I was like, what do you mean a secret Supreme store? They said, if you pay me $20, I'll take you to a secret Supreme store. So we're gonna, and that's where I went. So we're gonna go take them there after we have lunch, and I'll show you guys where the original Supreme reseller store in New York all started from.
Wow, that's crazy. People are lining up on a normal day, I thought.
And there's nothing even there.
So we're gonna go back to the restaurant now and we'll grab something to eat first and then show you guys the secret Supreme store. So we're getting a macaroni, a waffle, and a egg benedict.
See, back then on the old Supreme, they would put all the style numbers.
Oh, I see.
Right?
Yeah.
They would get very detailed about everything.
Oh, look at this.
Yeah. It's so
feels
different.
Vintage.
Vintage, right?
Hey guys, so we just finished lunch.
What do you think of it?
It was amazing. It was worth the wait.
Yeah. High quality.
Yep. Lunch was amazing. We're going to go to the car now and drive to the Supreme secret store. So see you guys there. So okay, I was talking about how everybody has a little bit of hypebeast in them. But people who just deck out in hype stuff, to me, it's not fashion.
I find that when it's too much hype in one outfit, mm-hmm. it's too overwhelming. Mm-hmm. You want to be able to break it down and mix like high end with low end, right? And once you find that good balance, it really becomes, you know, much more versatile.
Guys, here we are on Elizabeth Street in Canal, and this is the Elizabeth Center. So the original Unique Hype collection, aka the Secret Supreme store, was over here. So you had to come in here and you come down these stairs here. So wow. Picture this, in 2008 when I came here with these two little kids showing me a Secret Supreme store, I was thinking like, what am I doing in here, right? You have to go down that escalator.
Crazy.
Yeah, like there are articles in the newspaper and everything about the owner Peter, who hopefully we'll see at the store, but it was located right here. This store here, this was the original Unique Hype, the first Supreme resale store in the world was right here. So now we're gonna head across the street to Unique Hype. So they moved from that location in the basement of the Elizabeth Center, right across the street to here.
Okay, so here it is.
Yeah.
Wow. I don't know if she allows us to film in there, so I'm gonna turn the camera off for a little bit and then let's see. This is such a historic store to the culture, and Aaron's is gonna explain to you.
Yeah, so basically, a lot of the Supreme resale stores you'll see around the world is they rely on kids and resellers to bring the products to them to resell. Unique Hype has been in the game from the very start, so them and Project Blitz are the only two places that have direct relationships with Supreme that they can afford to, you know, continuously have the newest stuff and at good prices for resale. So that's what makes this place special and Project Blitz special.
How long has this place been?
I'd say around 2005, 2006 is when they first started.
And the first store, as we showed you guys, was there.
So unfortunately, they are not allowing us to film in there, which is understandable.
Got some good B-roll though, right?
A little bit. And the reason why we bring you guys to these places is because we want you to know how the culture has always been. It's always been limited.
Because Supreme always produces limited quantities. To the fact that now there's so many resellers involved in the game, it shifted the dynamic from people who want the item to wear to now people just want the item to sell, right?
Exactly.
And that's a big thing. Like, such as a piece like that I'm wearing now, that's back when people bought this item, they actually wanted it for its purpose. Nowadays, if this were to release today, how many people would be buying it just for their resell? That's when it comes down to, are you in the game for the love of it, for the culture, or are you in the game just to make a quick dollar out of it? And that's where you have to decide for yourself. Because there's a lot of like nice looking box logos and nice looking Supreme designs that people like, but you know, because the resellers, they control the market, they can't afford to be spending, you know, thousands for a t-shirt or thousands on a sweater. And that's what's special about the Some Notice brand, because the whole thing behind the Some Notice t-shirts is to put out quality designs that use the history from Supreme's past into the future without, you know, making you spend $2,000 on a shirt, but
exactly,
still having that limited focus where you can still feel special by owning this piece.
So me and Aaron are actually gonna head back to the hotel now and show you guys a little sneak peek about what we've been working on. Let me tell you,
everything is top secret.
Everything. It's gonna be crazy. So we're gonna head back to the hotel now and see you guys at the hotel, okay? What's up guys? So we're back at the hotel now and I want to show you guys something crazy that me and Aaron are working on, and I guess the best way to show is just to show you,
right?
Here it is.
Let me give you guys a quick breakdown. So if you guys have been following the Some Notice brand, and I'm sure if you guys have been subscribed and you guys have watched Ben's channel, you guys would see that he actually did a review on a couple of the past releases. The whole influence behind the brand is it's paying homage to the old Supreme box logo designs in still limited quantities. However, you guys do not have to pay thousands of dollars, and you don't have to go through the hassle of trying to locate them, making sure that they're authentic, and you know, just like the whole hassle behind the Supreme box logo phenomenon, because we know that they can go anywhere from like $1,500 to like $5,000 for the t-shirts. And the main reason why I really wanted to partner with Ben is because we both have a great passion for not only fashion but the whole culture as a whole. So this is a great way for us to give back to you guys. So if you guys are familiar with Supreme, you guys would see that this is the Tokion box logo back in the year 2000. So 18 years ago, Supreme collabed with Tokion, who is the largest magazine company in Tokyo, that is similar to Complex. So they do a lot of cool stuff with toys, fashion, art.
And the reason why this has so much meaning to us as a collective is because I never found any company, I never found any brand that I wanted to collab with. Aaron, he first contacted me and I was like, man, this is perfect.
So to give more background on the design specifically, this skyscraper background is the original location for Tokion's head office here in New York. So me and Ben first connected here in New York City.
Yep.
Our favorite city to shop, to eat. We have such a deep passion for Tokyo culture, and what better way to celebrate this with than the Tokion box logo that's very iconic. If you do your research on it, the original Supreme design, if you were to find that, it's very hard to find. It's reselling for over like $5,000.
It's impossible
right now
to find.
So it's like, it's very hard. You can see it from the sideline here, the BT logo.
So as you guys can see, this is the BT logo with the Some Notice logo. We've been talking a lot about Japan and how Japan is so authentic. It's so organic.
They pay a lot of attention to the details from not only who's designing it, but the meanings behind each brand. So when me and Ben first talked about working together, is we had so many great ideas together, but nothing really came about until we just started talking about what we really like from a cultural standpoint. So we've both been to Tokyo, we both understand how they're so submerged into the culture where, you know, they don't just follow trends, they really embrace the whole meaning behind each brand,
they
whether
really
it's Fate,
embrace
Supreme,
yeah,
their own brands, so like W Tops. Mm-hmm. If you just see, we also talked a lot about Nigo and Pharrell, how both of them came brought different things to the table to form Vape and BBC. And that's what we wanted to try to connect into something that is streetwear oriented, but pays tribute to not only the history behind Supreme and Tokyon, but from a cultural aspect.
Japanese streetwear, they really incorporate it into their lifestyle.
And a big thing is, so from the Some Notice brand, we've done 34 releases and have never done a collab yet. So this will be our brand's first collab with Ben. And there's no better way for us to celebrate, you know, 2018, a new year, with such an iconic box logo design. We've taken you guys today to around Soho, to the original Supreme store. That was the very first location they opened back in 1994. And then we brought you to Unique Hype, where that's the very first Supreme resale store. So we've taken you through the history and the stages behind the Supreme streetwear brand and what's made it such an iconic identity today. And, you know, I'm just so happy that to have met such a passionate person like Ben. And he's not only eager to know about the design, but more about the history behind the design. Because me and Ben have been talking about now today, so many fast trends that are happening mm-hmm. in the hypebeast world that it's easy to get lost in the world and just buy.
And just lost the appreciation.
Yes. And the stories behind it. So a lot of people that even today that you'll see have the Tokyon box logo,
yeah,
they might not know the meaning behind it.
Exactly.
Like back in 2000, right? That was Tokyo's version of Complex. How big is Complex to our community today? I went to ComplexCon this year. I was fortunate enough to go to the convention. Over 50,000 people were at ComplexCon.
That's crazy.
Just to
That's
embrace
crazy.
The culture of like sneaker releases, t-shirts. Mm-hmm. There were so many vendors there. Tokyon was the original Complex in Tokyo back in the 2000s, and that's why Supreme collabed with them, because Supreme already knew that at that time they weren't as big as today, but they were still on their way up. Mm-hmm. So the same way Supreme paid attention to the iconic companies like Tokyon, such as what I'm wearing, Patagonia, their eyes were already set on building something bigger than just hype. And that's what me and Ben are really trying to give back to you guys at a very affordable price.
You guys know that I've never done any collaborations. I've never promoted or review any of the brands for money. I'm 100% being authentic and transparent here. I'm not doing this for the money.
Yeah.
You know, the reason why I decided to collab with Aaron is because he has the same mindset. We're not doing this for the profit. We're doing this because it feels right.
I just see that the market today is so oversaturated with so many resellers that it's lost the love. Because nowadays, I think it's disgusting that so many kids have to spend thousands of dollars just for a box logo t-shirt. A lot of times they get scammed too, because they don't know what's real, first of all. Sometimes it's bad condition.
Yeah.
A lot of times you can't find your size.
Exactly.
And it's just a headache. That's why the Some Notice brand was so integral to the growth of just box logo identity in general. I've never done a Tokyo box logo, and this is something that, you know, Supreme has, to this day, they never re-release anything, and this is one of the hardest box logos to get. So I think that me and Ben right now, we really pooled our thoughts together in an organic way, and this is what we came up with.
I'm sure many of you guys who already bought Some Know This shirt, you guys know that Aaron really, really took care of every single detail about the print, you know, about the fit. That says a lot about a brand, you know? Mm-hmm. There are so many ways to make a quick shirt that you can sell for a quick profit, but not a lot of people
put their thoughts and love into the design. I don't have that depth and knowledge as Aaron, so that's why, you know, having him in this collaboration really helps me to understand a lot more about the culture. Not everyone has the access to $1,000 t-shirts.
For a t-shirt, yeah. Fashion, you should be able to wear and enjoy what you purchase. And that's another aspect that I feel, strongly feel, that's missing in today's world.
Okay.
Where people don't wear their stuff.
Mm-hmm. Some Notice has always made only 100 shirts for every design,
yeah.
For every design.
The whole purpose too with keeping it to 100 shirts is because not only is it a lot of work, because each t-shirt is hand folded, hand packaged, and delivered to your address. So I'm not a big company. I don't have a whole line staff of workers who can, you know, pump out thousands of shirts. Also, if you look at the quality, all of the properties here are using Diazo and SBQ technologies, where it's not just a normal press that's just
you can feel
at
it.
Your house.
You can
shirt.
Feel it.
These are all professional grade screen prints. The same way that Supreme, when they screen print, you know, when you put it in the wash, it's going to be the same way after, you know, there's no cracking. I really pride myself in taking the time to put in the quality and the workmanship in behind each design. And I'm happy that my first collaboration is with someone who's as passionate about the fashion and the culture like me as Ben is.
We haven't have a date yet to release this shirt, but we will definitely see you guys on the next vlog to talk more about the release date and how to buy it. We're obviously going to talk a little bit more in depth about the design as well. Mm-hmm. And I think this is going to be sick. We'll see you guys on the next vlog. And definitely we're going to try to make this purchase as fair as possible
for everybody.
For everybody.
Not everyone is obviously going to be able to get it, but you know, we want to make it as fair as possible so everyone has a fair shot at getting a shirt.
So yeah,
we'll keep you updated, guys.
Let's continue.
Peace, guys. Yeah,
I'm gonna get cap. Yo, so I hope you guys like that. And we're on our way now to Barney's, and we're probably gonna hit some other shop as well.
Barney's? Yeah.
Yo, this is my first time in the cab.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Oh yeah, the last time we were just taking Ubers, right?
Whoa. What is this floor?
Tom Brown. Right now we're on the fourth.
We're in
this
fourth?
Is like some sports wear stuff, you know? See that? 810. That's not bad, eh?
Yeah, it's not bad. Every brand right now is trying to have like a street touch to it.
Mm-hmm. Streetwear touch, yeah. Mm-hmm. For sure.
These pants.
Good quality, eh?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we're gonna go see 6 and 7.
6 and 7.
So this is third floor. This is where everyone wants to be on, all the designers.
Comme des Garçons. Balmain. Amiri. Mastermind. We actually have JC here from Urban Necessities.
Wow. Look how many.
Yo, the layers. Yo, layers.
Look how many.
This piece is nice. The wash is nice.
This was started by the guy who was originally designing Balmain.
Wow.
He started this, yeah. That was when Balmain was heavily in.
Yo, this piece is actually really nice. The drawstring doesn't look as cheap as the other one. Palm Angels. 424.
This visitor on Earth. This brand was started by Kanye's boy. God's messenger.
I'll show you come
I
down.
I forgot you're going to Aruba.
Calabasas, eh?
The quality is not bad.
Yeah, not bad.
Gosha.
Gosha.
I don't know what's special about Gosha.
Just hype, right?
Yeah. Fear of God. Varsity jacket. These are so heavy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Gee. So that was Barney's, guys. I think I didn't shoot the intro for the for Barney's. So Aaron, do you want to explain?
Yeah, so Barney's, that's the largest retailer in New York for, you know, men's fashion,
high fashion,
where they have a good combination. They have the designer shoes, you know, 8 floors, and 4 of them have like a lot of stuff that you guys would be interested in. So if you're in New York, make sure you check out Barney's.
It's actually so cold right now. It's so cold. Oh my gosh. We're heading to Bergdorf now. It's in Fifth Avenue, and Fifth Avenue, để bên đó tiếng Việt, Fifth Avenue là một cái đường mà có rất là nhiều các cái designer store, rất là nhiều high end store. Và bây giờ bên chúng đi vào Bergdorf. Bergdorf thì cũng giống như là Barney's, nó cũng là một cái department store. Và đây, để tôi show cho mọi người, Fifth Avenue is so beautiful, so beautiful. Okay, we're at the 3rd floor in Bergdorf right now. I really like the design of the store. It's just more, you know, it's more friendly. Yo, I'm about to show you guys a Japanese brand.
There it is.
Ready-made, all made in Japan. See that? You have to know that. Each one of these are placed in my hand.
The price is crazy.
But the quality is amazing.
Yeah, the quality though. Oh, feel the lining.
Like all these pins were inserted. Fishtail parka, it's all written by hand.
Wow. You know? So these are all written by hand.
This one, look at the patch. Detailing.
Wow.
All stitched in. I mean, it's just lined. It's a good jacket.
Canada Goose. You see the patch in here? These are some dope winter jackets. Balmain. Fear.
Here we have Kith, a 2017 sensation.
To be honest, their pricing are really like affordable.
I like these pants.
Where are these made?
Zach.
Well, now Zach.
Well, Zach,
but...
You had that lodge, I don't know. Well, like, we need to
find out
what the... Can I see this? Sure. Oh,
you're recording?
Yeah. Oh, good.
Okay.
Nice,
yeah, it's nice. I don't know. I still like the card holder.
Oh, you like the card? Okay.
Yes.
No filming inside the store.
Okay, sorry.
Thank you.
They're in line.
So we hit a couple of stores today, and we got to show you a lot of places. Hopefully we're gonna see you in the next vlog with updates on the shirt, and we're gonna announce the release date as well. Now we're gonna go down to the basement area.
I think Aaron wants to get some cake.
It's a tradition, you know? After you hit Bergdorf, you have to come to the plaza across the street where they shot Home Alone 2, the movie. Come down here to Lady M.
Call it how it is. Hendrix. I promise you, swag.
So here's the Lady M booth. They don't have a lot of selections.
So unfortunately, they are out of
the cake.
And honestly, pictures just don't do justice. Like, even the looks of the cake just doesn't do justice.
Yeah, you got it. That first bite is everything.
Oh, wow.
It's from the sauce.
Wow, guys.
So this is probably the last place that we're going to hit. Me and Aaron are going to see each other soon for the update on the shirt. And hopefully we can have the release date to you guys as soon as possible. And for now, thank you guys for watching. I'm so excited for the shirt. Obviously,
it's a big moment for everybody, you know? It's something we worked really hard on and thought out thoroughly. Not just the hard work, but to think it through, yep. I think that's the hardest part.
And also, I just feel really lucky to be collaborating with Aaron because he has a lot of knowledge on the culture.
I'm happy to share it too, you know? It's one thing to have knowledge, another thing to be able to share it.
Yeah.
And I'm so happy that you have the same passion that I have for the streetwear culture and just fashion in general. Very hard to find.
Well, you know.
And we want to share it now with everybody so everybody can feel involved and part of something bigger.
Okay, so thank you guys for watching. See you guys on my next vlog. And good night. Peace.
Yo. Percocet. Miley Percocet. Percocet. Miley Percocet. Rep the set.